The National Wild Turkey Federation has taken a focused approach to conservation through their America's Big Six of Wildlife Conservation. Six regions encompassing 738 million acres were identified to address the most urgent needs and better focus resources. These regions are America's Western Wildlands, America's Great Open Spaces, America's Crossroads, America's Mid-South Rebirth, America's Southern Piney Woods, and America's Colonial Forests. In these regions, the NWTF and its partners are taking conservation delivery to a whole new level.
For that animal, and you get to enjoy the work that you put into it. You get to see pretty much full circle of it coming to you, and then all these unique dishes you can make.
At NWTF, hunting heritage is literally part of our mission. We believe in doing what we need to pass on our traditions of hunting heritage, but also to secure funding for conservation in the future. Participation in hunting has been declining since the 1980s, and this is particularly important to the conservation community because license sales and equipment help fund conservation. NWTF has hosted events to pass on our hunting heritage since the 1980s, and those events have changed over the years. We started with the Jakes program in 1981, and since then, those programs have evolved to include new audiences and different ways to engage people. One of the things that we put a lot of emphasis on is learning. People want to not only come to an event or come to a hunt and have the experience, they also want to learn all of the fundamentals and safety, all of the things that go along with hunting. So it's more than just a one and done type of event. They need multiple events. And our chapters facilitate these all across the country. We work with other conservation partners, we work with federal and state agencies, and we also try to connect folks with land that they can go back and hunt on in their own communities.
So there's almost sort of a backstory for this in order for it to have to make sense. Basically, the idea and what makes America unique is that we have a public funding mechanism for hunting and angling, which pays for a lot of conservation. Pittman-Robertson is an act that dates back to the 30s, which stipulates that a certain percentage of ammunition sales, firearm sales, go back to the states following a formula, and these are to be used only for hunting and wildlife habitat. And so those are the funds that underwrite my job description. And so in some ways, I think of myself as working for the hunting public. And so because hunter and angler numbers have been dropping off, and as baby boomers age out of this pursuit, the question becomes, who is gonna pay for conservation? And so in some ways, the rationale for an R3 coordinator is to help find new streams of outdoor enthusiasts who are going to help fill the ranks of the folks who are a very avid generation and who are aging out. The big picture here is we're trying to rebrand hunting and bring in new streams of hunters. And you can kind of see, if you look across a broad stripe of publications, anywhere from Outdoor Life, Field and Stream, New York Times, Wall Street Journal, there have been articles about this phenomenon of food and hunting and the new generation getting into that. And so I'm trying to capitalize and bring in this new group, as well as keeping the traditional recruitment cycles within families intact. And then also to sort of message that hunting is about connecting with the natural world, it's about conservation, and it's about food, and it's about, you know, a wonderful social environment.
So I grew up in Sheboygan County, Wisconsin, on a small family dairy farm, and was also fortunate enough to have grandparents that had land up north in Wasaki, and they lived on a lake, and that they taught us how to fish, watch birds. So it really just all ties together now, because I didn't become a hunter until 6 years ago. I always liked the hype coming up before the 9-day gun season. It was always my brother, my grandpa, my uncles going up for the deer season. Back then, it was very much a guy thing. And once I moved back here and that hype, I wanted to learn how to hunt, but I really wanted to know the basics about everything. At that time, I was afraid to touch a gun. I've shot a gun a few times before, and it'd be with my brother, but he would load it and hand it to me. So I needed like the very basics of like, where's the front, where's the back, how do you load it, how do you shoot? And the DNR Learn to Hunt program really broke it down for you that way. And then you got to see the mentors, how excited they were about their experiences and sharing their stories. So I started out with deer gun hunting, but I've really expanded over the past few years. I've tried deer bow, squirrel, rabbit, pheasant, and turkey, and now turkey's my all-time favorite. You know, I think it's one of these great things where everyone's so connected with technology now, to whether it's hunting, but for people to find their interest and go out and do that without, you know, finding a partner in mind, but that way you might stumble upon someone that has similar interests in you. And when I get that moment of harvesting an animal, it's really great to be able to share it with someone there.
I say this pretty often, and maybe not everybody feels this way about hunting. If I didn't have people to share it with, whether I go out by myself or with somebody, if I didn't have anybody that cared to hear my stories or, you know, look at pictures, I don't know that I would go out that much. I can get meat in other ways. Just the idea that you can share that with somebody and they listen and there's some interest there is what really makes hunting worth it to me. It kind of hardens the importance of the fun.
Most organizations in the conservation community have been focused on R3 in the past couple of years because it's opened up a world of science to us. We are digging into what makes an individual want to become a hunter, stay a hunter, or leave hunting altogether. One of the ways that we found to be most successful is through food. Food is a common factor for all people. We all have to eat, so food is a great way to connect new audiences to hunting.
The central impetus behind us getting involved with Hunt for Food is that we happen to eat meat. It's just part of what we do. I personally feel that hunting gives you a different respect for the animals that we're harvesting and collecting, and it adds a more reflective relationship with the food that we're consuming.
I think the Hunt for Food program is incredibly valuable, and you know, I know of people in other places and other states that have participated, and other people have participated in other parts of Wisconsin, and I think growing it is, it's a great way for adult onset hunters to meet people, have a peer group, and start to meet mentors that you can participate with, and that camaraderie, which is like such a huge part of hunting. I think the other thing that's hugely valuable is it gets out the message about conservation that if you didn't grow up in hunting, you don't really understand, you know, tags and bonus points and buying permits and all the money and, like, you know, the Pittman Roberts that comes in through these tax programs. That's really the reason we still have wildlife. And I think that's a story that we don't really tell in pop culture and in the public as much as we should. And it's a great value, even if somebody just comes once and they go to a program and they go away knowing that, like, hey, a huge amount, if not all, of the conservation dollars in the area that I live in are coming from people who are participating in hunting. I think that's really valuable to preserving that hunting culture and changing some of the maybe pop culture perceptions that people might have of hunters. And that was huge for me because I didn't really realize that before I got involved. And now that's like a a point of pride in terms of what you're doing, but also emphasizes the importance of attracting new people to the sport to ensure that we maintain that revenue stream for continued conservation efforts in the future.
Initially, I think 2011 was the first Hunt for Food class through Wisconsin DNR, and it's very interesting to bring these folks out who are, they're outdoor enthusiasts. I mean, they've backpacked and canoed and hiked and wilderness camped, but they don't know how to pick up a firearm, you know, or a bow. And so that's kind of my role or the mentor's role to help give them the skills and to give them the opportunity to see if they like it. They all come out of this class with a message of a very positive view of hunt. And so this becomes a good sort of meeting of the minds or a place where people that are interested in hunting can learn all the skills and the story, you know, that hunting funds conservation.